السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته، أخباركم يا شباب؟ Today we will explain the extraction of iron. In the last session we explained information about the iron and we said that iron occupied fourth position after oxygen, silicon, aluminum and iron. Number two, we said that iron represents about 5.1% from the Earth's crust. Number three, we said that the iron found in form of ore in Earth's crust and found in pure form in meteorites by 90%. And we explained the validity of iron ore. And we said that the validity of iron ore depends on number one, the percentage of iron in the ore. Number two, the composition of impurity in the ore. Number three, the harmful element which found in the ore. And we explained the type of ore which we extract iron from it. And we said that there are four ore, hematite, limonite, magnetite, and siderite. And we indicate the chemical name, the chemical formula, the percentage of it, the percentage of iron in each one of the ore. And we explain the extraction of iron. We explained that the extraction of iron best through three stage, dressing, reduction, production. In the last session, we explained the ore dressing and we said that dressing of ore aim to improve physical, mechanical, and chemical property. At first, we explained the physical and mechanical property and we said that improve physical and mechanical property take place by three step. Number one, crushing process. Crushing process means that break the iron ore to obtain smaller size in order to be stable for the reduction process. After that, some of fine ore produced from crushing we can't use it directly in reduction process. So we make process known by sintering. Sintering means that collecting fine ore which produced from collecting fine ore which produced from crushing and the cleaning furnace in larger size to be similar and homogeneous to Swiss reduction process as shown in the figure. Number three, concentrating process. What's meant by concentrating process? Concentrating process here means that increase the percent of iron, the percentage of iron in its ore. How we can increase the percent of iron in its ore? We can do this by removing the impurity and unwanted material which found in the iron ore. Again, how we can remove the unwanted material and impurity? How we get read from it. We can get from this impurity and unwanted material by three step or three method: surface tension, magnetic separation, electric separation. These are three step used to get rid from the impurity and unwanted material. Today we will complete the lesson. Today we will speak about improving chemical property of iron ore. improving chemical property of iron ore roasting process. Roasting, what's mean to by roasting? Roasting mean heat strongly. Roasting mean heat strongly. So roasting process and extraction of iron mean that heating iron ore is strongly in air. Why? Why we make roasting for iron ore? As we know before, iron extracted, iron ore extracted from the earth's crust. So iron may be contain humidity, maybe contain water vapor, maybe contain carbon dioxide like iron dicarbonate. So we can get rid from all by roasting, by strong heating. So number one, roasting means that heating iron ore strongly in air to increase the percentage of iron. So there is a question, very important question. This question says that we can get rid or we can increase the percentage of iron physically by concentrating, but chemically by roasting. So the iron, we can increase the percentage of iron chemically and physically. Chemically by concentrating, physically by roasting. Roasting, heating iron ore to get rid number or letter A, drying the ore, expelling humidity to increase the percentage of iron in the ore. Roasting of the dried ore, FeCO3, heating carbon dioxide gas evolve and form FeO. But FeO oxidized by oxygen because we make or we did heating for iron ore in air. So FeO react with oxygen and form iron trioxide Fe2O3. So by summation the two equation, we found that FeCO3 plus half O2, it gave Fe2O3 plus CO2. Number two, roasting of limonite. Oh, roasting aim to convert oil, iron ore into hematite. We convert oil. Iron ore into hematite because hematite more easily reduced. And we said that there are four iron ore. Number two, limonite, Fe2O3 points H2O. By heating, it gives to Fe2O3 plus 3H2O. As we know, two means that there is no 2 mole, but 2 from its chemical structure, from the chemical structure of compound. But, or so, 1 mole of limonite by heating it give 2 mole of Fe2O3. B, oxidation of some impurities, sulfur oxidation, phosphorus oxidation. We can get rid of sulfur and phosphorus by oxidation in form of sulfur dioxide gas and phosphorus pentoxide gas. Second, reduction of iron ore. Reduction of iron ore. The first stage, we make dressing. We make dressing for the iron. We prepare the iron to the second stage, reduction of iron, and we convert all iron ore into Fe2O3. So in the second stage, the compound ore, the iron ore which started the second stage start by reduction or by iron trioxide hematite. We can reduction mean that get rid of oxygen which found in Fe2O3. And to get rid of oxygen, we make reduction by two furnace, blast furnace and matrix furnace. When we said we make reduction or do reduction for iron ore, so we must have reducing agent. What is the reducing agent in blast furnace? The reducing agent in blast furnace, carbon monoxide. And how we can obtain carbon monoxide? Carbon monoxide gas, we can obtain it from coke. We can obtain it from coke, like coke carbon react with oxygen. By heating, it give carbon dioxide. So carbon dioxide react with carbon and give carbon monoxide in blast furnace. So after that, we prepared the carbon monoxide. So we used or we used carbon monoxide in reduction process. So Fe2O3 plus 3CO at 700 degree. It gave iron plus 3CO2. In matrix furnace, the reducing agent, water gas. Water gas, we can obtain it from methane. By the reaction of methane with carbon dioxide and water vapor, it gives water gas. Water gas in this furnace used as reducing agent, but Fischer-Tropsch used it to convert into a liquid fuel. It's very good. Reduction reaction. After that, after we prepare the carbon monoxide and H2, it's water gas. We used it in reduction of Fe2O3, Fe2O3 plus 3CO plus 3H2. It gives Fe plus 3CO2 plus 3H2O. Question mentions the role of coke in the blast furnace. When it burn in hot air, it produces carbon dioxide, which react with excess of coke, producing carbon monoxide gas, which act as reducing agent. Water gas role in the matrix furnace differ from its role in Fischer-Tropsch method. As we said, in matrix furnace, water gas act as reducing agent, but in Fischer-Tropsch converted into liquid fuel. The last stage, iron production. Iron production, after we prepared or obtained iron by reduction, the iron which produced from reduction, not used in pure form, and contain some of impurity. We must get rid of impurity which found in the iron which produced from reduction furnace. So the third stage, iron production. After reduction of iron ore, here comes the last stage, which is production of different type of iron. We produced cast iron and steel. But the steel production depend on two main process. What are the two main process? Number one, the removing of impurity which found in the iron resulting from reduction furnace. Number two, as we said before, iron not used in pure form because it soft, not hardness. So we add other element to iron to give the produced steel the required durability for industrial purpose. After that, the steel industry carried out by it or the furnace production, oxygen converter, open hearth furnace, electric furnace. So the furnace of production, oxygen converter, open hearth furnace, electric furnace. But if the questions, what are the furnace of reduction, blast furnace, and matrix furnace? Thank you very much, and I hope to understand this lesson. Thank you very much. In the next lesson, we will explain the alloy and the alloy the last part in this lesson. Thank you very much. Goodbye and good luck.